Good morning, students. Next topic is a constructor. So what is a constructor? A constructor is a special member function for automatic initialization of an object. A constructor is a special member function for automatic initialization of an object. What is called a constructor? Whenever an object is created, the special member function, that is constructor, will be executed automatically. So when the object is created, means the constructor will automatically executed. Okay, so how to write an constructor, or syntax rule for writing constructor? The constructor name must be same as that of its class name. So when you define a class name, the constructor name should also be the same. Okay, then it is declared with no return type, even void, just to give the constructor, that's all. So it cannot be declared constant or volatile, and it may not be static, it may not be virtual. It should have public or protected access within the class, and for some rare circumstances it should be declared as private. Normally we use the constructor only in the public functions. Okay, let us see. So the concept of the constructor in C++, a constructor is a special member function whose task is to initialize the object of its class. When it is created, it is special because its name is same as the class name. It is called constructor because it constructs the value of a data member of the class. The constructor is invoked whenever an object of its associate class is created. Now what is that? Let me see the syntax, general syntax. So the class, first name of the keyword class, then name of the class declared by the user, then under private we declare the data member and member functions, then public we declare the data member and member function, and then we have to declare the constructor. So here class name, so this is the class name. So it has given as a member function with no return type, even void. Like that protected, we define the data member and member function. Okay, so here we see the example. Simple example, sample is the class name. Under private, XYZ are data members of int type. Then under public, here we define the constructor. So this is the this is the constructor, and this is the get data and display are member functions whose return types are void. You note that the constructor has no return type, even void, just the class name, that's all. Now let me see one programming example. Constructor example. Copy. Okay, let us see that. Right. First, include IO string, then class sample, name of the class. Then I am defining, declaring two variables, x and y, as integer under private category. Then under public category, here I am defining the constructor, that is the sample, and then get data whose return type is a void, and then sum is an integer value. So under constructor, so how to define the constructor means here class name. Class name is a sample, then scope, resolution operator, then member function. The member function is also sample. This is the class name, this is the constructor name. Okay, here I am assigning x equal to 10 and y equal to 20, right? Then another member function, int sum. So return type is a int, class name is a sample, scope resolution operator, then sum. I am defining the local variable z as an int, then z equal to x plus y. So here I am assigning 10 and 20, therefore now z becomes 10 plus 20, 30. Then see how sum of x and y, that is 10 plus 20 equal to z. Here z equal to 30. So return 0. Then under main, first declare the object. I am using obj for as object. So class name is a sample, then object. After that, object dot sum. So here get data is not necessary because here we are assigning the values in the constructor itself. Okay, now let me execute this program. Now run this program. So what happened here? The sum of x and y equal to 30. So x is 10 and y equal to 20. That is assigning within the constructor. And then we find z equal to x plus y. So that is the message here. Sum of x and y equal to z. Z equal to x plus y means 10 plus 20 equal to 30. So the main we call the object sum. Okay. So this is the constructor. I think now you can understand what is constructor. Now let me see another program. Okay, next. So what is a destructor? A destructor has the same name as that of a class or constructor to which it belongs to, followed by a tilde sign. That is, destructor, which is used to destroy the object created by the constructor. Okay, so the destructor rule is similar to constructor, except that the first character is a tilde character. Okay, you see the keyboard, the tilde character. Then the rules are same. That is, a destructor function name is the same as that of class it belongs, except that the first character of the name must be a tilde character. It is declared with no return type, not even void. Okay, it cannot be declared as a static or constant or volatile. It takes no argument and therefore cannot be overloaded. The overloader concept will be seen later. Then it should have public access in the class declaration. Okay. So here these rules, syntax rules are given. Okay. Now, right. This is the constructor. Now, first character is a tilde character, then sample. So this one is a destructor. Are able to follow? So this is the constructor, okay, and this one is a destructor. Here the difference is, yeah, the first character should be a tilde character, right? The same programming example, let me declare the destructor. So first character is a tilde, then sample. So this is the declaration of the destructor, and then sample class name, then scope residual operator, after that the destructor. Yeah, cout. Object has been destroyed. Okay. Now this is the definition of the destructor function. Now we execute this program. Right, so sum of x y equal to 30, after that the object has been destroyed, right? Now you can understand what is constructor and destructor, right? So next class we see various types of constructors.